One day a man came to Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, the famous tabi'i, and asked Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala about the situation his city was facing at the time, which was a drought. Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala responded by saying, the solution, the remedy for your situation and your city's situation of this drought is none other than istighfar. Do istighfar, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man left. Another man came to Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala and asked Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala regarding his situation. This man was facing poverty. This man had now become a destitute. Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala responded by saying, do istighfar, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This man left. Another man came and asked Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala regarding his situation. He asked Hasan Al Basri that, I cannot bear any children. I do not have any children. Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala said the same answer, do istighfar, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man left. Another man came to Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala and complained about his gardens, saying, my gardens are not producing any goods. My gardens are now becoming dry. Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala responded again by saying, do istighfar, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man left. Another man came and approached Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala and asked him, O Imam Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, why have you given the same remedy, the same solution to each and every one of these individuals? They each had different situations and scenarios. Hasan Al Basri rahimahullah ta'ala said, this is not my solution. Rather, this is the recommendation and the solution and the formula given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. In Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quotes Nuh alayhi salam by saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, quoting Nuh alayhi salam, استغفروا ربكم, seek forgiveness from your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنه كان غفارا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala verily, certainly, definitely is the most forgiving. In return, once you do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the skies filled with rain, abundant in rain. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you in wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you in children. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make luscious gardens for you. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. And He will make rivers for you. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we may be in any of these situations or circumstances, the solution is in the Quran. The solution is to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, think about this. We sin knowingly and unknowingly. In return, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us, just ask forgiveness. I will forgive you. On top of that, I will increase you in your wealth. I will increase you in your kids. I will increase you in every good thing. Subhanallah, this is none other than the Almighty Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it comes in hadith, Ya ayyuhan nas tubu ila Allahi wa astaghfiruh, fa inni atubu fil yawmi mi'ata marra aw kama qal. O mankind, seek forgiveness and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For verily, I repent and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 100 times a day. And this is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most blessed human being to ever walk on the face of this earth, the most noble being, asking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while he had no sins to begin with. You and I are sinners. You and I commit sins knowingly and unknowingly. When we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will verily forgive us because he's the most forgiving. And on top of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase us in our family, will increase us in our wealth, will increase us in all the good in this dunya. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows each and every one of us to make istighfar a part of our daily routine.
If you haven't done yet, please subscribe to our Muslims 365 YouTube channel, press the bell icon for the latest updates, and don't forget to like, comment, and share on the videos.